So what's up, Jay Bathers? This episode has two parts because the story that Kumar Uncle told us is a story filled with adventure and adrenaline. You can imagine what would it take a guy to travel from a place like Gujarat on his Royal Enfield motorcycle, crossing over into 20 different countries, moving to London eventually. So this is the time I want to take to tell you guys that me and my team puts in a lot of hard work behind each video. So if you guys are watching this on YouTube, do not forget to subscribe to the channel because we need subscribers. There's no shame in saying that. And if we have more subscribers, I can bring better guests to you. I'm pretty sure this journey that Kumar Uncle had is extraordinary. And because it was such a lengthy episode, we had to split it into two parts. I would also want to at this moment thank our title sponsors, Pac-Man, which is a friend's company. They have like crazy customizable gifts that you guys can select on all virtual platforms. They have presence on Instagram everywhere. For this particular video, because we have split it into two parts, the video will be available on IGTV as well as YouTube. If you are on IGTV, my profile is quite open. You can follow it if you want to. And on YouTube, don't forget to subscribe to it so that every time we put out a new podcast, you guys would be the first one to get a notification in your email or wherever. So yeah, enjoy episode 2. Jibbat. Jibbat. So did you encounter any biker gangs and what was the interaction like?
See, when you go to Russia, Night Wolf is got a strength of more than 10,000 bikers. Night Wolf.
Okay.
And it is the biggest biking gang in the world.
Okay.
They are known for all the nonsense you can think of, yes. You know, they can do. And there is a place in Moscow, Russia. Moscow is the capital.
Yeah.
Where bikers get together every evening.
Okay.
जैसे हम लोग चाय के लारे पे पटरी पे आ जाते हैं
हाँ,
तो हाँ, चल वो हियर फॉर एवरीबडी इन मॉस्को गेट्स टुगेदर एट स्पैरो हिल.
What is the place called?
Sparrow Hill. Okay. And Sparrow Hill pe you can find at least 500 bikers there at any given time.
Okay.
In summer.
Yeah.
Because they can ride only for 3 months.
Yes.
Or 2.5 months. But it's no other. Okay. They make the most of it. Rather they hardly sleep. I asked my friends which I had made. Well then you sleep for 2, 3, 4 hours. You have to ride. You have to enjoy this, you know, riding. And they all use fancy vehicles. मेरा बुलेट देख के तो दे वर स्क्रैचिंग द हेड के व्हाट सॉर्ट ऑफ इंजन इज दिस. मैक्सिमम पीपल आर केम एंड आस्क्ड मी कि व्हाट इज दिस. आई सेड इट इज फ्रॉम द वर्ल्ड ओनली, आई एम नॉट फ्रॉम द ऑटो प्लैनेट. एंड अबाउट
दे मस्ट बी यूजिंग हार्लीज एंड एवरीथिंग, नो, लाइक
यू कैन नेम द बाइक, इट इज देयर, लॉट्स ऑफ सेकंड हैंड बाइक्स अवेलेबल. एंड इन द इवनिंग व्हेन आई हैड स्पेंट ऑलमोस्ट द होल डे विद 8 बाइकर्स हु बिकम यू नो वेरी फ्रेंडली टू मी. एंड they were actually given to me by another friend, you know, like take him around kind of thing.
Okay.
It's very important to have contacts everywhere. So in the evening, I just, while we were sitting, you know, and having chai, I said, let's go to Night Wolf.
Okay.
So my friend came to me and nudged me like that, with the hand, you know. So I told him, what happened? He says, no Night Wolf. I said, why? He did not reply. And all the 8 people, one by one, they all went away in different groups.
Okay.
So I understood there is something serious about Night Wolf which these people are not comfortable with.
Talking about also, yeah.
So I told my friends, you come or not, I am going. Then they started explaining, you know, this happens in Night Wolf and that happens in Night Wolf. I says, yes, but I am just going to have a look at, I am not going to interact with anybody there. And it was about 10 o'clock in the night.
Okay.
So it was approximately about 30 kilometers away. And you know, went into Night Wolf. All of them stood outside.
Yeah.
They said, we will not come in, you go. So we took photographs from outside, I went inside. It's a huge ground where all these spare parts of bikes and tanks and artillery and all.
So
and they made different things over there. Very pretty. And even their club inside, their bar and their place to
bikers have a staple bar, right?
Yes.
Every biker club has their own bar.
So there were a few bikers there. I went inside. I just, you know, took photographs, tried to talk with the bartender, one or two bikers, and the night wolf ka photograph tha, which I took. And it was a very different experience.
Yes,
and I went it with no fear because I didn't really know so much about them.
Huh.
When I came out and the way people told me, this is not a place to go.
Huh.
You should not be there, you know.
Okay.
I said, anyway, I wanted to go and I've been and I'm happy about it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
so
it's something you take off on your list. And as long as they don't see you as a rival biker gang, everything is fine. If this, if they thought you were from a rival biker gang, what do you think would have happened?
See, my homework. We do like preparation when I said 18 months. Homework says that in Russia the police are extremely corrupt.
Corrupt, yeah.
So keep 10 color Xerox of passports. This is from all the reading I did.
Okay.
So you should always carry with you, but never give your original to them.
Yeah.
Because first thing he'll do is take your passport and go into the office and sit. You won't come out for 1-2 hours. So what you are doing, you are standing there. And then he will send somebody to ask you for money. $500. The change you are supposed to keep in your pocket is not more than $10. Now, this is again from my notes.
Which
I made from different riding groups.
Okay, nothing more than $10.
So you take out your purse and show him $10 here. And a lot of riders, lot means a few riders. What they had done is they waited for an hour. Bike chalo karke bhaage. ठीक है तो क्या वो चाले यू नो चिल्ला चिल्ला के वापस आए और कुछ नहीं दे विल नॉट फॉलो यू बिकॉज़ दे वर डूइंग रॉन्ग सो सच थिंग्स वी डिड एनकाउंटर
ओके
सो द फर्स्ट पर्सन जब रशिया से हम लोग बॉर्डर के कजाकिस्तान से रशिया तो व्हेन आई एंटर तो अबाउट जस्ट अ किलोमीटर देयर वाज अ चेक पोस्ट पुलिस चेक पोस्ट और मेरे दरगन धार 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 तेज हो गए एंड इट वाज अबाउट 6 o'clock इन द मॉर्निंग
ओके
एंड ये मोटी मोटी चेन्स विद यू नो पॉइंटर्स ऑन द ग्राउंड
ओके
बाजू में टेंट
स्पाइक्स
हां प्रॉपर उस तरह टेंट सो इफ यू डोंट रियलाइज कि ये पुलिस है यू विल जस्ट गो थ्रू
एंड
बोथ योर
टायर्स विल बी व्हिच
आई न्यू कि ऐसा होता है तो मैं विजिलेंट होके निकला था और सुबह 6 बजे वो हाथ किया उसने रोको तो धीरे धीरे बाइक रोका और स्टार्टेड स्पीकिंग स्लोकास इन माय माइंड आई वाज बॉस दिस इज आई जस्ट वांट टू गेट थ्रू दिस बिकॉज़ आई नो हाउ बैड इट कैन बी यू नो हेल्प मी गॉड व्हाटएवर इट इज एंड दैट फेलो कॉल्ड द बॉस एंड द बॉस वाज एप्रोक्सीमेटली 6 feet 7 inches With a machine gun just lagging as if it's a small danda, and you know, pistols and all, it came and in his, sleepiness.
Okay.
Because it was in the morning.
Okay.
So before I could, I said, good morning, sir. Dada. Then he looked at my bike number. IND India. I said, Das, sir. Then he jumped in front of my bike. I wish I had my camera on that. And started singing, I am a disco dancer.
He did that.
Oh my God. My tension, my worries, my concern, everything just with a flip went down. Okay, it was just too good. And he says, India, go. And I found this behavior very strange. I said, why is he allowing Indians to go?
A 6-foot guy singing that song with a machine gun hanging.
Any song, you know.
Yeah.
I knew Raj Kapoor is very popular, but I didn't know Mithun is so popular.
Okay.
And everywhere I went after that, only this one song of Mithun.
Everyone
did sing. Everybody sing. Only one song. Whether it is a street, audio playing somewhere, a party, this song is always played.
So they must have seen some clipping of this song in some Russian movie.
No. When I came back, I questioned a lot of my friends, myself. Okay. Mithun was a communist.
Mithun Da was a communist. That's why.
He was an accelerate before he joined the movies.
I did not know that.
Please check. So, that is why he was so loved over there.
Okay.
And Raj Kapoor is just a Bhagwan, you know, over there.
Because
the movies is made on Russia and all.
Yeah.
In Kremlin, there's a lovely statue of Raj Kapoor.
Okay.
So, These are the experience like.
We can talk about that one currency exchange. What currency did we talk about?
It was a tenga.
The photo. Denga.
Tenga. T-E-N-G-A.
T-E-N-G-A. That is the currency of?
Uzbekistan.
Okay.
So, you know, when Uzbekistan was so strict, as I told you.
I think it's this one, no?
Yeah, it is this one.
And you got this in exchange of?
$100.
$100.
1,90,000 tenga.
Tenga. Okay.
So if you buy a bottle of water, it's 10,000 tenga.
Okay.
You have a separate 70,000 tenga.
Okay.
But where, how do you carry? You know, pockets also, we had to get a small pouch.
Okay.
To carry all that. It's quite frightening, you know, foreigners.
And you had grown your hair, sir, as I can see in the picture.
It was quite long that time. I love that.
Yes.
I'll tell you one very interesting thing about my hair.
Okay.
I am not a fashion person. I am not, you know, I didn't grow my hair because I was a rider.
Yeah.
I grew my hair to challenge myself because I am a shy person.
Okay.
You know, I had one hairstyle since my birth.
Okay.
Or since I grew up in school.
Yes.
And I never changed it. So I said, let me change something.
Okay.
And I challenged myself and did this.
Okay.
About maybe a year and a half before.
Okay.
So, I started growing it, and of course, in India, people comment directly of hair. Hey, kya kar raha hai? I say, whatever, I want long hair. And you have first problem starting from your house. Your wife will question you, mother will question you. I say, whatever, I want to grow it and let it go back like Delilah. Samson and Delilah, like Samson, not Delilah.
Okay.
It's the whole story of the hair, you know, which is very powerful.
Yes.
And that's how I grew my hair, just to challenge myself. Hardly, you know, knowing about that this is a fashion for bikers to, you know, do that kind of thing.
Great, sir. Any particular, when you crossed into Eastern Europe, like after covering, I think, what was the first country that you crossed into in Eastern Europe?
Eastern Europe, we wanted to go through Latvia, Lithuania.
Okay.
But as I mentioned earlier that, you know, from entry of Russia because of no entry to Ukraine, I rode right up to Petersburg.
St. Petersburg.
And then changed my plan overnight.
To include the Scandinavian.
To go to not include. To avoid that time, even in Lithuania, there were, you know, parts of disturbances.
Okay, okay.
And Belarus had a lot of disturbances next to it.
Belarus was
so bad. I said, why get into all that jamela? And then went through, you know, the three Scandinavian countries, Finland, Sweden, and then Denmark.
Okay. But Finland must have been very cold, right? Even in summers, I think Finland is. Did you encounter the northern lights anywhere? Like, why?
No. Northern lights in Norway.
Norway, Norwegian. Yeah.
No, we didn't go to Norway. Okay. We went almost near the border.
Okay.
One strange thing about Norway locals is near the border, we met people, you know, hundreds of cars coming this side, going to a big store which was there, buying Coca-Cola and things, and going back into the country.
Okay.
Because there's no duty.
Okay.
But coke and all is very expensive in Norway. Okay. So people drive to the borders,
they buy
things somewhere and go back. Okay. Lots of things. But that is a way of life. But Northern Lights we didn't encounter. We didn't go into Norway at all.
But I think Finland also, some parts of northeastern Finland, say, I think they are visible.
They are visible, but
they must be very
first
often.
Of all, I was not aware of it. So, and my only motto in the entire journey was to meet other riders.
Okay. Yes.
You know, I contacted so many and my interest was riders. I didn't want to go and see, you know, museums or, you know, landscapes, whichever came on your route, yes. Okay. But otherwise, I didn't go off my way to do that.
One of my female friends, Karishma, if you are watching this, shout out to you. She's based in the United States and she has taken up riding as her only profession. Like, apart from her work, which is all work from home, she just rides through United States.
Wow.
Like, every week she's in a different part of the United States and she's constantly riding. So yeah, after her, I think you are the most riding conscious person that I've ever come across, even on social media. So how did this entire idea come to your mind, sir? Like, ki silk route karna hai, because this is very unconventional. Common riders would think of ke chalo Bombay Goa kar lete hain ya Delhi se Leh kar lete hain, but India to UK, that would be something extraordinary. Now, apart from your college days, I know you have been planning this since your college days, but at the age of 53, what motivated you to take this journey on?
See, why it took 30 years, this is a very small explanation. I believe that whatever dreams people have,
yes,
they never die. They are always in your subconscious mode.
Okay.
And as you grow up, then, you know, duties of life, I got married, had children, schooling, college, you know, I had to get them off. And my son was doing his final CA when I was on this tour. I wanted to take him with me.
Okay.
And he said, Dad, take me. I said, I can't postpone this. He said, there's no way. Otherwise, I would definitely take. And so, there came a time in my life where I had almost, you know, enjoyed, done all my things I wanted to.
Okay.
And in 2005, before 13, I got my heart attack.
Okay.
And I got 3 heart attacks in one night.
Okay.
And a stent was put in my heart.
Okay.
So from that year onwards, I had more advisors than friends. Even I tell you, friend, just baat baat mein yaar mere ko lagna, arre pagal ho gaya tu.
It's time.
Arre yaar pagal ho gaya tu. So the heart patient hai. And so much so that the near and dear ones will also tell my wife. Arre please tell him, and they will come up with photographs. Dekho Uzbekistan mein these 4 riders ka bike hi chori ho gaya. Ye police pakad ke ja rahe hain. With proof and all. And that created a lot of, you know, problems getting, you know, 100% permission from my family. But I was very adamant. And then I finally convinced them. I said, see, I'm not a madman. I'm not going for racing. I'm not going for comedy. I'm not going to jump off the hill. I just go, like, I'm traveling in India, I'm going to travel there. He says, no, buddy, you're a heart patient. I says, heart patient means there was a clog, like we have in a motorcycle in the jet. वो साफ कर दिया वो साफ हो गया अरे नया हो गया
अब क्या
इज हाउ कैन यू टॉक लाइक दैट सो व्हाट इफ दिस इज हाउ आई लुक एट लाइफ
एग्जैक्टली व्हाट अ स्टेंट सर्जरी इज
दैट्स व्हाट आई लुक एट लाइफ यू नो आई सेज इफ आई वॉक डाउन फ्रॉम द हाउस एंड आई कोलैप्स देयर व्हाट विल यू डू व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन इज इनएविटेबल बट दैट डजंट मीन आई स्टॉप लिविंग इन फैक्ट आई मेड ऑल माय यू नो थिंग्स आई वांट टू डू बिफोर आई डाई फ्रॉम 2005 ऑनवर्ड्स एंड वर्क बैकवर्ड्स I finished my golf, I did my scuba, I did a lot of things.
Okay, okay.
You know, which I wanted to do. And that's how it was.
Okay. So, sir, coming to one part of your journey which was very interesting, I think your suspension or something broke, cracked during the journey. What is that?
There was, when we went, finished Uzbekistan and entered Kazakhstan. Venue karke, there was a small city about 80 kilometers from the border.
Okay.
And without 80 kilometers, it was 10:30 in the morning. Hardly did we know that that entire road was not made only. Or they were actually going to make another highway.
Okay. So it was not like a proper road.
No, proper means you could not even walk fast on it. Itna kharab. तीन फुट के बड़े बड़े गड्ढे थ्रू आउट सो एक्चुअली इफ यू बिलीव इट विद माय व्यूअर्स यू बिलीव इट तो 10 किलोमीटर या 15 किलोमीटर से ज्यादा ये बाइक चली ही नहीं एकदम स्लो 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 एट अ हाई गियर रेशियो इट्स नॉट यू नो डन बट व्हाट टू डू मेरा पूरा लगेज इतना ज्यादा था इट वॉज हिटिंग फटाक फटाक
एंड एट दिस मोमेंट आई वांट टू टेल द व्यूअर्स दैट सर डिड नॉट हैव अ बैकअप व्हीकल व्हेन दिस हैपेंड
नो
ऑल
आई डिडंट हैव द लक्ज़री ऑफ बैकिंग बैकअप व्हीकल नो
दैट इज सो ट्रू डेड डेविल ड्रीम आई डोंट थिंक एनीवन इवन इन माय एज ग्रुप वुड बी एबल टू डू इट पॉसिबली नहीं है सर
सी बात ऐसी है ना आई वाज कैरिंग 42.5 किलोस ऑफ स्पेयर पार्ट्स
ओके
इंक्लूडिंग एक्स्ट्रा हेड एंड ब्लॉक
ओके
सो पूरा मोटरसाइकिल मेरे पास था इतना स्पेयर पार्ट था और 2 टी शर्ट्स ड्राई फिट एंड 1 जीन्स
ओके
आई हैड पैक्ड अ लॉट सेवरल टाइम्स पैकिंग किया था फिर नहीं ये नहीं चलेगा इसके बिना चलेगा इसके बिना चलेगा करके आई केम डाउन टू ऑल दिस
ओके
फाइनली क्या याद आया कि भाई हर एक कंट्री में जीन्स फेंक दो दूसरा ले लो कौन सी बड़ी बात है व्हाई डू वांट टू पैक डोंट मेक अ जमला ऑफ वेट और ये वेट डाल के हम लोग इंडिया में काफी चलाया था मैंने कि भाई कोई प्रॉब्लम तो नहीं है पर इंडियन रोड्स है अवर रोड्स आर बेटर देन किर्गिस्तान उज़्बेकिस्तान कजाकिस्तान एंड पार्ट्स ऑफ रशिया मच बेटर एंड नाउ अवर रोड्स आर एज गुड एज देयर रोड्स सो ये कैलकुलेशन था ही नहीं और हमारे मैप रीडिंग में देयर वाज नो इंडिकेशन कि देयर इज अ डाइवर्जन वो जो हम लोग जाने लगे तो वेरी डस्टी और इतना पवन था एंड एट टेम्परेचर अबाउट 46 दैट टाइम तो करीब 40 किलोमीटर गए होंगे एंड सडनली बिग नॉइज ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड एंड लकीली हमको लगा नहीं हो स्प्रिंग निकल गई उसका पूरा राइट सस्पेंडर टूट गया कैप निकल गई स्प्रिंग वेंट इन टू द फील्ड
So it literally gave way, the spring broke and it flew away.
Yeah.
Oh my God. That can be a nightmare.
How, what do you do?
You didn't even crash.
No, nothing. It was still... Fortunately, touchwood, pura jani mein itna bhi kuch nahi hua. Lekin, aisa ho jaye to kare kya? So I thought very obvious, we'll stop some people, take a lift and go. You know? Only three big refrigerated vans aaye the. जो क्रॉस किया तीनों को रोका तीनों से बात करने की कोशिश की वो खाली ये दिखाया कि रेफ्रिजरेटेड वैन है हाउ कैन बी हेल्प मी और 10:30 बजे निकले थे ये शाम को 6 बजे ये ट्रक्स 3 मिले थे मतलब आज की रात तो इधर ही सोना पड़ेगा रास्ते में
एंड यू आर मेंटली प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर इट
नॉट मच बट या बट वन नाइट या वी वर नॉट कैरिंग टेंट मेरा खाने का सामान निकाल दिया था मेरा कुकिंग सामान निकाल दिया मेरा मसाला निकाल दिया था रीपैकिंग में मालूम पड़े इसके बिना चलेगा इसके बिना चलेगा तो वी डिडंट हैव मच बट ओनली थिंग इज हमारा जो राइडिंग गियर था इट इज गुड टिल 15 डिग्रीज बिकॉज शाम को बहुत ठंडा हो जाता है उज़्बेकिस्तान इज एक्सट्रीम क्लाइमेट
40
एंड 15-12 डाउन
-12
प्लस विंड तो डेजर्ट एरिया में अगर विंड होता है So that is a chilling factor. Otherwise, if it is -1 also and no breeze, it's still you can manage. So I had practiced how to sleep on the bike. So that is how you know some
You had practiced how to sleep on the bike.
Yeah, yeah, of course. You have to. Suppose like you got stranded like this. You know how to keep your bags away, support rega, you know, little damage
there.
करके रात निकल जाएगी बट वी वर वरीड अबाउट दी यू नो रेप्टाइल्स स्नेक्स एंड ऑल बिकॉज आई नो डेजर्ट्स हैव अ लॉट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम विद स्नेक्स एंड उज़्बेकिस्तान हैड ट्रेमेंडस स्नेक्स ऑन दैट साइड Then 118NE करके एक गाड़ी आई दूर से देखा मतलब ये तो इंडियन गाड़ी बट एक्चुअली इट्स अ रशियन गाड़ी रशियन गाड़ी पूरा मस्त सारा तो मतलब आई वाज वेरी हैप्पी फाइनली कोई आएगा मैं किसी को मिलूंगा तो हुआ ऐसा कि वो गाड़ी को हमने हाथ करके रोका
तो पहले तो वो लोग भी डरेंगे
नहीं वो लोग नहीं डरे नहीं वो रुक गए और ट्राई टू एक्सप्लेन गिव मी लिफ्ट आई वॉन्ट टू सिट और पहले तो अंदर देखा तो गाड़ी में 7 adults थे और 4 children थे सब चिल्ड्रेन 5-7 साल के थे मतलब मेरे लिए इसमें तो जगह ही नहीं है सो थोड़ा बड़ा टैक्सी ट्रक पुट मोटरसाइकिल यू नो ऑन इट एज जो भी कुछ मैं कोशिश किया उनको समझाने के लिए कि आई वॉन्ट अ लिफ्ट टू गो टू वेन्यू तो मैं ट्रक लेके टेम्पो लेके आऊंगा इधर बाइक डाल के चला जाऊंगा तो काफी बात किया उसने उसका बूट भी खोला बोलता फुल ऑफ वाटरमेलन था नो नो नियत 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 करे ऐसे चलो भगवान की मर्जी जो है चला गया वो चला गया तो हम लोग सब सामान वामान निकल के मैं सो गया बाइक पे तो आफ्टर 1 घंटे के बाद वो गाड़ी वापिस आई
लेने
आफ्टर 1 आवर
Okay.
Now it was coming back, so I thought इस तरफ जा रही है. I didn't realize कि same गाड़ी है. वो गाड़ी आई, वो turn मार के खड़ी हो गई बाजू में. तो तब मेरा दिल धक 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 होने लगा. मतलब बस ये प्रॉब्लम है ये सारा को यू नो ही वांट समथिंग फ्रॉम मी टू एडल्ट्स लड़के आगे बैठे थे तो वो एक राइट में से निकल के वो आ गया बूट खोल दिया वाटरमेलन सब नीचे डाल दिया मतलब पुट योर लगेज इनसाइड तो मैं तो डर गया मतलब मैं नहीं करूंगा मतलब तुम जाओ उनको नहीं चाहिए
हां ये लास्ट
टाइम यू ट्राइंग टू हेल्प 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 एंड देयर वर फोर लेडीज दे आल्सो केम आउट यू नो ब्रो नो कम इन देयर ओन लैंग्वेज व्हाटएवर इट इज तो आई टोल्ड देम आई विल सिट फर्स्ट यू पुट माय लगेज इनसाइड मारो खाली टैंक बैग मेरा सिर्फ टैंक बैग था तो बोले टैंक बैग मैं हाथ में ले लिया जिसमें मेरा कैमरा यू नो डॉक्यूमेंट्स वगैरह और बहुत बड़ी इम्पोर्टेंट चीज है उनको टेल पासपोर्ट हमेशा पॉकेट में रखनी राइट हैंड या लेफ्ट हैंड पॉकेट राइडिंग सूट में जिप्स होता है अदरवाइज जीन्स इज द बेस्ट कीप योर पासपोर्ट डोंट कीप इट एनीवेयर एल्स नॉट इन अ बैग
मैं सर इसमें मेरी एक ट्रिक शेयर करता हूँ कि देयर आर पाउचेस जो यू कैन पुट इनसाइड योर बॉडी आल्सो
हाँ
I used to keep it there when we went to Europe as well.
Very important, very important.
Passport.
So, finally गाड़ी में बैठ गए और चले आ गए. इतना serious atmosphere था, तो I tried to make conversation. They started telling Hindustan, Hindustan. हाँ, दादा Hindustan. Buddhist, Buddhist. नहीं, ना बोले Hindu. So they don't understand Hindu. They only know Buddhist. I said, okay, Buddhist, no final. And you know, slowly, some conversation started breaking.
Okay.
And there, you know, very pretty daughter sitting behind us. So she asked for my mobile. And I was playing Hindi songs that time because they all would know about it because Hindi songs are known in that area.
Okay.
So she asked for my mobile. So I was wondering what does she want to do. And you know, she you know deletes some important files of mine of root and things like that. I gave it to her and then every now and then looking back. Then the lady next to her is saying, name, Nargissa. Sunil Dutt, Nargissa. So I was so happy, man. I said, wow. She thinks that she is Nargis.
Okay. Yeah.
And that's how the conversation just started.
Okay.
And they turned out to be wonderful people. They were all messengers. To help us in a dire strait.
All this, do you think destiny has some role to play in all these people you meet on such a journey?
I'm sure.
Okay. I'm sure. So how did we get to this marketplace where you found the?
Okay.
Those are those suspension springs that you.
Yeah.
Okay.
See what happened is you know this was in Uzbekistan.
Okay.
In Kazakhstan, when we left the border, we got to this place called Benue.
Okay.
And like I mentioned that the bike suspension broke on the way to Benue.
Okay.
And somehow, you know, we got the vehicle to Benue afterwards at night, late night.
Okay.
पूरी रात तो सो गए थे क्योंकि इतने थक गए थे हम लोग साढ़े चार बजे से चालू किया था. And it was about 12:30 at night when we reached. और 12:30 भी daylight है.
हाँ.
उधर रात
ज़्यादा होता नहीं. हाँ हाँ.
So very tired when we went to sleep. कल बात करेंगे उसको भी पूछा जो driving कर रहा था कि सस्पेंशन मिल जाएगा दादा कैप्टन सिंह यस 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 ठीक है तो सुबह ही हम लोग टैक्सी हायर किया मैं टैक्सी लिया एंड उधर काफी कार के यू नो वर्कशॉप्स थे सो वर्कशॉप पे गया सेकंड वर्कशॉप थर्ड आई रियलाइज दिस इज ओनली फॉर कार्स देर आर नो मोटरसाइकिल्स इन उज़्बेकिस्तान नो नॉट अलाउड
No bikes.
Therefore, I understood why the customer was getting so funny with me.
Okay.
You know, by keeping my bike for two days. There are about 300 bikes in entire Uzbekistan, and one club runs it. वो club को भी हम लोग मिले थे. रात को चुपके से 11 बजे के बाद वो club चालू करते हैं. एकदम soundproof area.
Okay.
There's a bar and you know meeting point inside. So we went there also. तो ये सडनली मेरे को स्ट्राइक हुआ कि जो मैं पूछ रहा हूँ उसको वो मना कर रहा है कि नहीं है नहीं है उसको क्या मालूम मेरे को क्या चाहिए ओके उसको क्या मालूम कि मेरे को ये स्पेयर पार्ट चाहिए बिकॉज देर आर नो बाइक्स तो आई वेंट एंड मैं दूसरा टैक्सी यार ये बोला टैक्सी आई वेंट टू द होटल वो सस्पेंशन दूसरा निकाला और उसको दिखाया मेरे को ये चीज चाहिए सो टैक्सी वालों से दादा एंड ही टुक मी टू सम प्लेस एंड वेरी स्ट्रेंजली आई थिंक बिकॉज ऑफ द डेजर्ट एंड द क्लाइमेटिक कंडीशंस देयर आर नो विंडोज इन द हाउसेस ओवर देयर ओके इफ यू सी वेयरहाउस वेयरहाउस मे बी 4000 स्क्वायर फीट एरिया बट इट विल जस्ट लुक लाइक अ शेड and everything written in the local language so you cannot know what is the inside so that fellow you know stopped and he says I'll go inside and check and he came back he says no, it's not there sorry that time I had not shown him the suspension so I told him we'll go back to the you know hotel I took out the suspension and we came back to the same place I told the taxi driver go inside we were looking for it And then there we saw this place where there were only two suspensions over there.
Okay.
Hanging. Kabadi khana of venue.
Venue.
Isme just
it was a scrap yard. Proper scrap yard.
Scrap yard.
Okay.
All small small tables the. Aur ek mil gaya to I was very happy. Then I told him dusra milega. Then he went home and got it. But that was bigger. Sorry, smaller than the size I had.
Okay.
So smaller you cannot stretch, but bigger you can hit and you know fit it. This was big by about less than a centimeter. So I say, इसको ठोक के कैसे भी करके set कर देंगे.
Fit कर देंगे.
Okay. So then we took a photograph and then he also asked me Indian rupee. So I had a 50 rupee note and I gave him. I was so happy. And I am still questioning myself. I have told my friends. Yeah. I've talked about it to a lot of people.
Yeah.
Why these two suspensions were lying over there for me? In a place where there are no motorcycles allowed, how can a motorcycle spare part also come here? It was for me. God's way to tell me that ye journey to boss aap complete karoge. You know, this is how I looked at
it. वो भी इतने टाइम से वो सस्पेंशन पकड़ के घर पे रखा होगा वो देखता होगा कि ये सस्पेंशन कौन ले जाएगा कब ले जाएगा and it took a 52 year old guy from India who traveled to Benue his suspension broke in the way and that's how he
sold that is how I got it
so this photo has a lot of meaning to it
very much it's very dear to me it's very dear to me and the best part is I'm still in touch with him
okay
when I went back in 2019
okay
I met him again So I he was there.
Our viewers, Swar has done this journey thrice.
Yeah.
Thrice. The same road, Silk Odyssey. Same, same and we can shift to the poster, jo sir ka poster hai. You have eventually, after people started talking to you, you tried to streamline this process for other bikers also, right? What was that about?
See, what happened is I wrote a book on this.
Okay.
But unfortunately, it's not published.
Okay.
The title of my book I have given is Ride Your Dreams.
Okay.
Because it's a dream of mine and everybody has a dream.
Yeah.
I am not trying to tell people you start riding. But those riding and those who have a dream of you know riding doing this kind of events, you must do. So I have named my title Ride Your Dreams and I have named my company which I am doing under this business of taking people from India to London.
Okay.
Ride Your Dreams.
Okay.
I have these you know beautiful t-shirts which I have made.
Okay.
So, initially what happened in 2013 when I came back, a lot of people had got to know and a lot of people came to meet me in Baroda कि हमको भी जाने हैं हमको मदद करो बोला ठीक है आपको क्या चाहिए तो किसी को planning wanted, somebody wanted the rules, regulations, somebody wanted, everybody gave everything. I says you must go. अहमदाबाद से भी आए थे बैंगलोर से भी आए थे काफी लोग आए थे इन ऑल अबाउट 13 और 14 पीपल हैड कम एंड आई गिव हिम एवरीथिंग छह आठ महीने के बाद जब फोन किया वाज डिड यू गो ही सेज नहीं यार हम लोग नहीं गए सम पीपल गिव वेग थिंग्स यू नो वी विल डू इट नेक्स्ट टाइम बट मोस्टली पीपल सेड यार अकेले कैसे जाए आई सेज मैं भी अकेला गया था People are very nice, you know. If you are going to be nice with everybody, people are nice. It's unfortunate that if you are at a certain place at the wrong time.
Yeah. That is
you can't help it.
Yes.
It's just coincidence.
Yeah. Like if but you are crossing through Ukraine and there is a gunfight going on and you are trying to ride
in. Yeah, you know, I mean,
it's a bad thing.
So it is just your bad luck if you are wrong, you know, present at the wrong place at the wrong time.
Yes.
But yet that fear is there in people. And I, as a human being, I love uncertainties.
Yes.
I love to go to uncertain place.
Mm. Mm.
So for me, it was more of an enjoyment and challenge.
Mm.
That is the way I looked at it.
Hmm.
I didn't look at a serious place. ऐसा होगा तो कैसा होगा ऐसा होगा. दो तीन plan बनाए थे. तीन plan भी नहीं चले. Russia से fourth plan बनाना पड़ा. So
that uncertainty gives you the kick.
Gives me a solid kick.
Yes.
Even now I go to places which are very small but they are beautiful.
Okay, sir. Anything in particular that you would want to add from your end? So, sir, the format we try to follow is Instagram, TV, and also 60 minutes is the topmost video I can upload. So, unfortunately, the stories would never end, but our podcast has come to an abrupt
definitely.
End. So, sir, what did you feel when you entered like the civilized part of Europe? Matlab, once you started entering countries like
Europe.
France and we have a picture of you in Paris, right?
Yes.
Paris picture, Ali.
At the Eiffel Tower.
Yeah, at the Eiffel Tower. So after you entered all these civilized nations, what was the feeling like? You were like, "Ha, journey khatam ho chuki hai, now I can relax." Aisa kuch feeling aaya tha?
See, this civilized places, like it is shown here on the tower, right in front of the tower. I wanted to take a picture because I was carrying my school flag and I'm very proud of my school which I've studied.
Your school flag wala bhi
hai. The Rajkumar College. This is school flag is there here.
Okay, isme bhi hai.
Yeah. So many photographs we took around the tower, but the whole tower was not coming. Next day in the morning and wherever we stand to take a photograph, there is only police on cycle over there. You know, they will come running behind you. Don't stand here because the traffic is getting jammed. There's so much of traffic over there. So we were warned a couple of times. This is bahut kya hoga, 120 euros fine karega na. But photograph to mujhe lena hai. Then first day kaafi liya, full tower jaisa aaya but did not enjoy. So next day morning, I found a place where this photograph is of Eiffel Tower. And there was some road work going on.
Okay.
So I parked my bike at ease, kept the camera on the ground, elevated the way I wanted and took a lovely shot.
Okay.
You
are also a photographer, right?
I'm a photographer.
Enjoy taking pictures. Okay,
I used to make documentaries earlier, you know, things like that.
Okay.
So this 2022, there is going to be a next ride.
Okay.
I welcome, you know,
viewers,
yes, bikers and cars. And this time is going to be even better because I'm going to do it from London to India.
Okay.
So we send our bike and vehicles by ship to London. I do all the logistics. You leave India, come back to India. I have a full package for you. So please write to me or my WhatsApp number is there on the photograph of the
and he'll add all source details in the video description and all
and
also eventually.
This is a dream ride. One cannot, you know, do such a journey because it's almost about 17,000 plus kilometers and a once in a lifetime experience.
Yes.
So go for it. That's what I would say. Ride your dreams.
Okay. So thank you viewers for tuning in. This was Kumar Shah and his extraordinary journey from India to London. He did it thrice. You can do it once. The opportunity is in 2022 and you can get the details from the video. You can personally call me also if you know me and
Can I add this? You said extraordinary journey. I didn't know. I don't know where you got that word extraordinary.
Okay.
Maybe I write it over there. That is why.
Okay.
Where did that word come in addition to the title?
Okay.
I first talked to, I'm still getting goosebumps.
Yes.
Because I can remember the feeling I got that time when I talked to Mr. Wilsmore, the owner of Ace Cafe. I took his permission and said, can I officially, because I just didn't want to finish my, you know, journey like that.
Yeah.
I said, can I officially come to Ace Cafe and complete my journey? He says, you're most welcome. And then after understanding what I wanted to do, he says, don't call this a journey. It's an extraordinary journey which very few people from the world also have made, because these countries people don't travel. You know, so I was so happy that is that the
premier,
is sitting.
The
yeah.
Premier biking.
It is the oldest biking cafe in the world.
Okay. Yeah.
Started in 1938.
Okay, in London, United Kingdom.
Yes.
So that's where you officially ended your journey.
Yes.
And with the permission of the
owner,
premier, yeah.
Mark okay. Wilsmore.
Okay. All right. So, sir, thank you for being on the show. It was a great pleasure on my end. Seeing you here, thank you for doing this.
Thank you, Jamin. I think this is a lovely initiative and this will go very long.
Okay, thank you so much.
And I love your symbol, the JB.
Yes.
Fantastic.
So Jebat, because North Indians
Jebat.
Jebat. Yes, Jebat.
Thank you so much for having me.
That's it. We end the podcast here. Thank you. Jebat.